What happened in our war could have been avoided? Managu asks Akeredolu. Welcome to the news and please subscribe to our channel to get notified when we post hot juicy news update. Please click on the notification bell. The thought of Nigeria in mourning over the massacre of people at St. Francis Catholic Church in our war. This senseless attack that was condemned greatly by many Nigerian celebrities. But Nollywood actor Uche Maduagwu appears to have his focus elsewhere as he questions the governor Akeredolu of Ondo State for not stopping the incident before it happened. He said, and I quote, "Dear governor, waiting you do with the alleged intel from DSS and Army, what happened in Owo could have been avoided as the chief security officer of Ondo State. You owe Nigerians better explanation, sir. I am going to lead a peaceful protest if Governor Akeredolu does not come out to clarify if he got credible intelligence from DSS and the Nigerian Army on the heartbreaking incident at Owo Catholic Church days before it happened. If he did, what steps was put in place to prevent it? Silent and complicity. Governor should stop playing politics with security. Enough is enough." Uche Maduagwu's post goes thus. "I am going to lead a peaceful protest if Governor Akeredolu does not come out to clarify if he got credible intelligence from DSS and Nigerian Army on the heartbreaking incident at Owo Catholic Church days before it happened. If he did, what steps was put in place to prevent it? Silence is complicity. Governor should stop playing politics. Security. Enough is enough." Do you agree with Uche Maduagwu's? Or do you think he's speaking rubbish about the governor allegedly knowing about it? Well, I've not read anywhere that this governor received credible intelligence. I've not heard anywhere. But if he really did, then I tell you he has some questions to answer. He indeed has some questions to answer. You said alleged intel. I think you should be asking the DSS and Army what they did to prevent the attack. A state chief security officer that doesn't have any control over the security agencies is useless. But let us not go too far. Let us be sure there's an intel first, then we know what to do next. Like I said, if at the end of the day he actually did receive intel as accused now by or as alleged as Uche Maduagwu. Yes, first of all, what steps did he take? Did he call on the DSS? Did he call on security agencies and they did not come? What exactly did he do with the information he had if he ever received an intel about this attack? Amateko have limitations, okay? And if you care to know, the only state in Southwest that have the best operating Amateko is Ondo State. Other states are just jumping up and down. Okay, I respect your response to this article. Those who give intelligence reports, what action did they take? Okay? If the DSS Army has an intelligence report that the bandits were coming to attack them, wouldn't they prevent it? Why would they wait for an order from the governor? Uche, you are mad. Okay, let's not go that far. Now, the thing is, first of all, make we hear whether this governor even called them. Yes, it is true that they're not supposed to call them, Sha, because we know that the state governor is not even in charge with DSS and security. You know now, state do not control federal-owned security agencies. Okay. You should tell us that he knows all about it. You tell us all he knows about it and this level of intelligence that made him to suspect Akeredolu's complicity. Certainly, he may have more to tell about it. What is the governor that's supposed to do something about it or those? Okay, was it the governor that is supposed to do something about it or those that have the intel? Okay. This issue is now very, very twisted. First of all, an incident happened and we are just hearing that there was intel on it. True. Those who received the intel,
good rapper for Governor Akare Idemdu, what would they have wanted him to do? All this is just these discussions now are what would have discussed way before this thing even happened. Yes, let it not be that, oh, they actually planned and did something, and yet at the end of the day, they could not avert it.
Because we really need to find out. Now the issue is twisted, yeah? So if the DSS, they got hint of this, what exactly? If you look at it, yes, Governor Akare Idemdu is actually the chief security officer of a state, but he does not control state-owned this thing. He does not. So, okay, were they saying he could have put measures in place by maybe calling on the Akoteku to do what exactly? Because first of all, like I said, the first step to this is let us confirm if really an intel was given. Then if an intel was given, what he did do with a piece of information. Let's just pause it there before we start going to, okay, the DSSC2 themselves, they have the intel and they did not do anything about it. In a situation where the army chief is Fulani, DSS to Fulani, intel provider might also be a Fulani, and the governor is not a spirit, how do you expect, or what do you expect, and your enemies are legion, the federal government is your arch enemy, as long as anti-open grazing is concerned? You people are beating around the bush. If you actually he got the information before now, what action did he take to avert this? If you don't trust security agencies because they are being suspected to be accomplices, did he inform at an Amotekun? Did he inform the traditional rulers and the clergymen? If not, okay, that is why I'm saying fine. Before we even move to start blaming the DSS, start blaming anyone, let's first confirm if we indeed got the intel. Our government takes everything for granted. If there is an intel, what happened in about what happened in Owo? As long as it is not about how our government will permanently remain in power, no action will be taken. It will be hard on the governor to explain to God Almighty what happened to his people under the governor's care. It is not enough to say, I want to be president or governor, just to chop money. You have to explain to your maker what you do to people under your care. Do you think that these people still have the fear of God? Do you think, first of all, a lot of eyes will be raised on this Uche Maduagwu Stoku. Uche, if truly the governor heard security information on this before it happened, it follows he is not responsible to his duty, so he will be dealt accordingly. Security fund is not his money. It is taxpayers' money, therefore should be utilized for such. Hence, failing to do that is a criminal act and can even lead to impeachment. Please, Mr. Governor, answer the question on your desk. Let's not go too far. Let's find out first if the intel was delivered to him or not, if he got the intel or not. On this note, we have come to the end of the news. We say thank you for tuning in to listen. Until I come here next time, enjoy the rest of your day.